that why did the Salaf As-Saalih, why they became from the most noble of people and the most honorable of people? What is it that made them have that izzah and that rank with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because they understood and they knew that it is not, the answer does not lie with the people. To please the people or to compromise your deen. No, they knew that it was with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let me just give you some examples of the Sahaba, of how they dedicated their lives. And the most important thing for them was the Akhirah, was with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What Allah thought of them. What Allah thought of them. Not what the people thought of them. Not what the societies thought of them. Not what the societies put, in what rank they put them in. But what was important for them is what Allah thought of them. Lend me your ears, my brothers, and listen to this. Sa'd ibn Mu'adh, radiallahu ta'ala an. An example I will give you of the rank that he had with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qala an-Nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ihtazza arsh ar-Rahman li mawt Sa'd ibn Mu'adh. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that the arsh, the throne of Allah azza wa jal, shook at the death of Sa'd ibn Mu'adh radiyallahu ta'ala an. And why? Why? Some of the narrations it mentions, because the farah, because the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal upon his soul ascending to his arsh. The pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal. And likewise in the Musnad Imam Ahmad, قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هذا رجل شهد له في جنازته 70,000 ملك. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said regarding Sa'd ibn Mu'adh at his funeral, there were 70,000 angels that attended his funeral. 70,000. So what is more beloved to us, my brothers and my sisters? What the people say about us? Or what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal thinks of us? Likewise, Sa'd ibn Mu'adh was from the Ansar, and he made a hukam against the Yahud of Medina from the permission of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so they disliked him because of that. And at his death, because he was an individual, Sa'd badinan, he was an individual that was tall and big in stature, so he was a heavy individual. But it mentions that the hadith that when they carried him, his body was light, the coffin was light. And some of the munafiqeen said that his coffin was extremely light, making mockery of this. And then this reached the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then he said, إِنَّمَا كَانَتْ تَحْمِلُهُ الْمَلَائِكَ مَعَهُمْ. That indeed, it was the angels that was carrying him. The angels came down and they were carrying. Look at the sharf. That is nobility, my brothers. That is the true honor, what lies with Allah Azza wa Jal. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would say, مناديل سعد بن معاذ في الجنة أحسن ما ترون. That the handkerchief of سعد بن معاذ in Jannah is better than anything which you see. وفي رواية خير ما في الدنيا. That it is better than anything in the dunya. So alhamdulillah, the strength. And what really matters is what Allah thinks of us. Wallah, I say to myself first, too long, my brothers and my sisters, we have been sleeping. Too long, we have left what gave honor to those before us. And this is why we are in the state that we are in today. This is why we have individuals pointing the fingers at us, because the shortcomings of our own selves. Another example I give to you, my brothers, that if you are loyal to Allah and obedient to Allah, Allah will not forget you.